Welcome, welcome everybody to another driveway workout, to another at-home workout. My name is Micah Babel, and I played on the WTA Pro Tour for about 10 years. And let me tell you, every day was leg day. Tennis pros never skip leg day. So today's workout features two rounds of specific drills that focus solely on your legs, and we're working on two footwork patterns in addition to that. So one will be how to move back and work on higher and heavier balls that push us off the baseline. And the other one will be how to approach shorter forehands and backhands. So a lot of leg work today. So get ready for that. Again, four rounds, three moves each, three sets. Okay, so let's get moving with our warm up. Making the transition from whatever you've been doing before to your workout. Glad you made time for it today. So just a couple of hops here, arm circles. And then jogging in place. We're starting nice and easy with shuffles and a crossover, just really playfully. Not that aggressive yet, we're just in warm up. So what you're working on is you're always using your outside foot to cross over in front. All right, and we need that crossover for recovery steps. We need it for our first step on the overhead. Okay, so come back and let's get into butt kicks. Really making sure that we get our legs warmed up. All right, skips. And then we're going with hip openers. So just imagine you're stepping over something, going backwards. We're doing the same thing going forward. And just some good core rotation here. Let's go with some higher knees here. Knees, let's get to 90 degrees. Don't forget your arms. For three more seconds, three, two, and one. And then just some ground strokes to warm up. So today's workout will not be as much of a cardio workout. Heart rate is getting up. It will be legs only, entirely. All right, let's go with some volleys. Just nice and easy. Getting everything warmed up. A couple more ground strokes, some overhead work. Too far over. Make sure you're getting into a 90 degree angle here. on your knees. So that's the first two moves. And the third ones are skater jumps. So you're jumping and you're coming forward as if you're skating. Okay, so we'll work on that. Three moves, skate jumps is one. Some call them curtsy jumps, I call them skate jumps. So lunges with a twist and skate jumps, grab some water. We are about to get started. So 30 seconds of each move concludes one set. All right, are we ready? Three, two, one, and go. All right, I'll do it without my racket. Lunge and a twist. If you want to make this a little more difficult, you can grab a weight, right? Maybe a med ball, maybe a gallon of water, whatever you have at home works. All right, and switch, left leg. Balance, find your balance before you push off. And keep your upper body controlled as you twist. That's the whole point. All right, and skate jumps. As you come back, skate. Up, balance, balance, balance. And of course, the more core strength and leg strength you develop, the better your balance will be. Yes, we will. Feel this tomorrow. All right, let's get ready in two, one, and I'll start with my left leg this time. Ooh, forgot the twist. Do this with quality. Rather have you do a couple less than rush through them. All right, 2 seconds. And I'm coming to the front again. Twist, push off back. Wobble, okay, let me find my balance. Then I twist, then I come back. Good, all right. Skater jumps. So forward, jump and you balance the opposite leg pulled in. Major things that happened in tennis during my career and then going on into the next generation was this used to be heavy workout stuff for my generation. This is warm-up stuff now for today's players. So the athleticism has increased in an incredible way on the women's tour. So again, top players use this stuff as warm-up. All right, we use it as our max effort to work out. That is perfectly fine. We're not pros. We're all on a different stage in our journey as tennis players. But wherever we are on our journey, we need strength, we need endurance, we need balance, we need coordination, and most importantly, we need to stay free of injuries. All right, here we go. And push off. 7 seconds. Find my balance, then push off. And I'm feeling that. All right, skate lunges. Don't forget your arms. They can help you really propel. And of course, they help you keep your balance. Last second. 1 minute break. Grab some water. We do need our rackets. Let me pause this for a little bit until I get my breath back. Now, what we're gonna work on is a specific footwork pattern on how to move efficiently back to higher, deeper balls that will push us off the baseline. So what I don't wanna do is, I don't wanna let a ball come up above my shoulder and hit down on the ball. That happens, let's imagine this is the baseline. Somebody hits a pretty heavy, deep, high ball. It bounces over my shoulder. I hit down, I lose control. So what I want to do is instead, is I want to drop back. I want to give ground and let that ball drop back into my strike zone, which is from shoulder to hip, right? And then I send that ball back high and heavy to give myself time to get back onto the baseline. And a lot of times that's just 1 or 2, 3 steps. Here's the way that you want to do it most effectively. So you see, on a forehand, I'm turning the right side of my body back. I'm pivoting on my left foot. I take my racket back with me. Then my next step is a crossover and then a side shuffle. So for most higher balls, 1, 2, 3, that should be enough for the ball to have time to drop back. Again, I hit it, come back forward. If you need more room to move back, that is when you shuffle. If you only can coordinate the shuffle, turn and shuffle, that is perfectly fine too. You can add the crossover at a later stage. What you don't want to do is this, right? You don't want to backpedal because you're not getting enough ground covered quickly enough. So, again, let me show you the pattern from the back. Turn, crossover. I load off my back foot and I send the ball back high and deep. Same is true on the backhand side. Turn, crossover, shuffle, I'm set now, and I send it back. And if I really do a good job loading off my back leg, here, as I'm hitting, my body weight transfers forward again. All right, so I don't want to deliberately jump. That's not how that happens. What I want to do is I want to load and push up, and that lifts me up, maybe, if I'm dynamically enough, but it definitely transfers me forward again. So, we're going high, heavy forehands, then we're going high, heavy backhands, and then we alternate. So, let's get ready. Less talking, more moving. 2 seconds. Ready, go. Always start your motion with a split step. Split, turn, crossover, hit. 7 seconds. Now we're going backhands. Now, of course, I'm going to do that with a one-hander, which is a little tougher. Because you guys, as two-handers, have the help of the left hand, of course. Right? But the footwork pattern is the same. Pivot on the right side of your body, bring the left side back. And now we're alternating. So forehand, backhand. Make sure you hit that ball high and heavy. Back, right, with a lot of shape. One more. Breather. So this is a very, very passive shot, but you can make it aggressive and have an aggressive mindset by how fast, how quickly, how dynamically you're moving back. But remember, you want to send that ball back with good net clearance for immediate height and, of course, for depth to keep the other person from attacking. So this time I'll start with my backhand. Get ready, 3 seconds. And go. Actually, let me do it from the back. And I can use that with my two-hander, same thing. We're going backhands. Forehands. And you see here, if I'm really loading dynamically, and then I push off, I lift, and I move forward again. Alternate. Alright, as you move back, make sure you take your racket back with you so that you're not just turning your upper body, but your racket is still out in front. So make sure you turn so that again, turn. And 30 seconds. So yeah, I told you it's not as much of a cardio workout, but if we're doing this right, yes, we will get a good, great heart rate workout as well. So, 2 seconds, let's get back to it. One more set. Crossover, and again, if you work on just turning and shuffling, that is fine too for the start. Okay, you can do that. The reason why we have this crossover is you can take a lot more ground quicker. So, last one here on the forehand. Let's go back to backhands. Go. Those are things, those were drills that I did hours and hours. All right, here we go. There we are, last time, 30 seconds. Alternate. Thank you. right, one more, one more. And 1 minute break. So again, for the next round, you don't necessarily need your racket. All right, these are oldies and goodies. Saying hi to neighbors. Always worrying what I'm doing. Talking to myself here. Actually, I'm talking to you and I'm getting you ready to do squat jumps, everybody's favorite. So what you're doing is you drop down and then accelerate up. Now, if you're strong enough, if your knees are healthy enough, after you come up, drop immediately back into your next squat and then accelerate up. If you're having issues with your knees, if you're having not quite as much control over them yet, and that includes me, what I'll do is I'll drop down, accelerate up, land, get my balance, then drop down. Okay, let's make sure of a couple of things. When I'm dropping down, this is not what I'm talking about. This is not what I'm talking about. Okay, so make sure that your legs are aligned, you're not twisting. So that is your squat jumps. The next one, crab walks. Okay, so again, we're dropping down and we stay low. We stay low the entire time, 30 seconds. So this is a drill where one of my coaches went around with a pool noodle. I don't know if one of us came up, whack. You got whacked into the head with a pool noodle. Thank goodness it was only a pool noodle. The last one is just regular wall sits. So we're going down to 90 degrees for 30 seconds. As I told you, it is leg day. All right, let's get ready. Squat jumps in 5 seconds. 4, 3, 2, 1, let's go. Okay, so drop and up. And really use your arms. All right, load and up. Use your arms. Do it with control. And get ready for crabs. Use your arms as balance. Don't want to have them just hanging here. Halfway there. Stay low with me here. Stay low. Wall sit. Back to a wall. If you have one, 90 degrees. If you don't have a wall, just go down and hold. All right, you can just go down into a squat and hold. Same thing. 15 more seconds. Keep breathing. Rest. All right, shake them loose in between. Get ready, we have 7, 5, 3, 2, 1 seconds. All right, we're going back to squat jumps. Make sure you drop down to 90 degrees if your knees are okay with that. One more. Crabs. All way, if you're struggling, just imagine how happy you're gonna feel when you are done. 7 seconds. Ooh, this is brutal. Just imagine how happy and proud you feel when you're done. Just imagine how happy and great that feels if you can still serve with a great leg drive at 3-all in the third set when somebody else is starting to crawl, okay? It's because you put in the work. So let's get back to it. Squat jumps. So my knees don't allow me to immediately go back into a squat. That is fine. I can still do this well. And again, always quality over quantity. Working for you right now. Don't work against it. Let it work for you. Again, project out to what you can do with that strength that you're gaining today. All right, shake it loose. Get back with your racket in your hand. What we're going to work on now is an approach shot. Okay, so approach shots, forehands and backhands. What we want to do on approach shots, is I'm going back to when I was taught, one of my coaches told me, you get up to an approach shot like a cat ready to pounce. So if you ever have seen cats when they play or when they're ready to pounce, they're not getting up there. And then they lower and then pounce. Now, they're staying low throughout. So, we're dipping down at the beginning of the motion. Here, now taking our racket back, and we're coming up to the ball. And as we transfer through the ball, we stay low, so that you're not popping up and then having to dip down again for your volley. Okay, so again, coming through. I do the same on the backhand side. I will work on my backhand as slices, and I stay low. Of course, you can hit a regular backhand, but you stay low, and you transition through. And then, of course, the third move will be we alternate. So, key points are stay low. Okay, I'm gonna freely borrow from one of the greatest volleyers on the planet, on the women's side, and actually on the men's side, I'm thinking, Martina Navratilova. Okay, you staying low, you can always overcome gravity if you have to pop up on a high ball, but you cannot overcome gravity if you have to drop down. Okay, so I think I did pay attention in physics. Law of gravity or whatever it was. All right, so get ready. Five. One, and go. Stay low. Okay, drop down. And I don't care if you approach your approach shot with a slide step or you're hitting a hop step. Whatever you're hitting, stay low. That's all that matters to me right now. All right, we're switching. I'm staying low. All right, I can drive it. That's fine too. One more. And rest. Before we get into the second set there, let me pause for 1 second. Just gives you a little bit more break. The reason why I prefer a slice on an approach shot is manifold. Number one, I have my continental grip. I'm coming in, and I already am in my perfect volley grip. So that's reason number one for me. Number two is a slice, if it's well hit, stays low. And ideally, that means that my opponent has to get under the ball and has to lift it up to me, which ideally gives me a volley above net line, which means that I can open angles, that I can really put away the volley. And then thirdly, a slice is a little slower than a regular drive, and that allows me to come in to net a lot closer, again, giving me a higher chance of actually having an up volley, a volley above net line. So that is why I prefer a slice on approach shots. So let's start with the backhand. Ready? Go. Stay low, stay low. Like a cat, ready to pounce. All right, let's work.
Get it, girl.
You can alternate, right, between a slide step, and then I'm coming across around with my right foot, or a hop step. Either way is fine. All right, alternate. Breather. Unless you're doing these workouts in the privacy of your own home, if you have a big enough living room or wherever it is, you will have people watching you, and that is okay. So, be proud of what you're doing. Do not care pay them no mind. Whatever they did, I think that was supportive. But there might be people who go like, what the heck are you doing? Hey, I'm doing something for my mental health, doing something for my physical health, and I'm doing something that I enjoy, even if it's difficult in the moment. So, keep on trucking, you people. We have 90 seconds. All right, ready. Actually, let me start with forehands again. Ready, go. Dip low, dip low. All right, dip in the beginning. Don't come up. Get ready to alternate. Last 30 seconds. Well done. Keep moving, keep breathing. Leg day, always fun. And yes, you do get a cardio workout as well. So I'm not quite sure what I was telling you before, that it's not a high intensity workout. It is, but we're done with it. So let's just shake it loose. Just hop a little bit. All right, shake out your legs. Wide lunge, get our hips stretched out. All right, now when you have your breath back again, a little bit, just soak in how good that feels that you did the workout. All right, we're switching. Let's go down and crawl. I believe it's called crawl in yoga. Kind of think of it as frog, actually, a little bit more. And come back up. Stretch. All right, you can hold on with two hands if you can balance it. when you're doing this drill perfectly fine. All right, what you're doing is you just take your left leg, we'll do it this way, put your ankle on your knee or slightly above, and then you dip down. So I'll do it here, and you should feel a very good stretch in your high knee. Whoa. One. All right, awesome. All right, so again, give yourself a big fat round of applause. Continue to drink. Always a good idea when you know that you're working out to start 24 hours before the workout to start drinking. Water, that is, and make sure that you keep hydrating after. So please subscribe to my channel and join me again at my next driveway workout.